with your eyes closed. With a sense of interest and curiosity. Asking the body, are you comfortable? Is there any way I can make you more comfortable, more at ease? And really giving the body that attention. The way you tuck in a child to bed. Checking they were comfortable, at ease, relaxed, warm enough. Watching them with love, allowing them to settle down. And again, at the beginning of the meditation, see if you can come in contact with your aspiration, with what you wish this practice to bring forth in your own heart and out to the world. Setting an aspiration at the beginning of the practice is like programming the mindfulness. Planting the seed of an intention that then develops in its own time. Such as, may my heart be open to metta, to kindness. May my mind be peaceful and well settled. Whatever it is that you wish to bring forth. And say this to yourself very clearly, maybe 1 to 3 times. Now just gently and calmly bring your attention, your awareness to the body. Remembering that awareness and kindness are like the light and warmth of the sun. Just allowing that sun, that warmth and kindness to sweep through the body. At your own pace. Spreading through every part of the body. Allowing the body to become more and more relaxed and at ease. letting go of any unwholesome thoughts or feelings that arise. It's okay for them to be there. But the Buddha said that you're ready to practice metta when they no longer obsess the mind. So now I'd like to invite you to choose a person, perhaps a friend or a parent, a child, maybe a teacher, a benefactor, with whom you have a loving, caring relationship, towards whom it's very easy to develop a feeling of goodwill. And take your time to choose that person, bringing them to mind. Perhaps bringing a sense of that person to mind if you're more of a somatic person. The sense of their presence or how it feels to be near them. Or perhaps a visual sense if you're more visually inclined. You might imagine them smiling. Or imagine a time that you shared together where you were happy, you enjoyed each other's company. And allowing that recollection to bring some uplift to the heart. Noticing the heart area. And as you connect to that person, bring forward maybe 3 wishes for that person. Knowing their joys, their challenges, their sorrows. What do you really most wish for that person? Which would be beneficial for them? And just develop 3 simple sentences. I like to choose positive words rather than an absence of something. So instead of free from suffering, I would say, may you be happy. Or may you be peaceful. May you be healed. May you be safe. Choose just 3 sentences which capture your feeling of goodwill towards that person. And while keeping that person in mind and keeping connected to the feeling in the body or the feeling around the heart. Just drop those words into the mind clearly, calmly, gently, giving space between each phrase to feel the emotional resonance, the meaning of that beautiful aspiration for your friend or loved person. So the intentions, the phrases, are not the metta themselves, but they're like seeds that you plant in the soil of the heart. Which give fruition later as the emotion of metta. So plant those seeds carefully, but then give some space between them, listening to where they're pointing to. Allowing the sunshine, the light and warmth, to shine in the heart area. Listening deeply to that emotional feeling in the heart, with patience, without demand. And finding your own speed. If the mind is more agitated, you may wish to repeat the phrases with less space between them, continually wishing that person well. Repeating the phrases carefully, gently, clearly. you continue attending to the words and to your heart, also keep that person in mind, the recipient of these well wishes. Perhaps imagining them receiving your wishes. Imagining them smiling, or maybe their face lighting up. Perhaps your wishes create a kind of golden glow around their body. Allow your perception to play in whichever way you find helps to generate feelings of goodwill. Again and again, planting the seeds of metta with the phrases in the heart, which is the soil, and giving your caring attention, which is the sunshine that makes them grow. you find your mind wandering, again, bring that person to mind. Remembering what they mean to you. Imagining them happy. And get back in touch with what you most wish for them. Carefully and patiently repeating your wishes again and again. Allowing the metta to develop in its own time. you find the metta starting to develop, or the mind becoming calm, you may wish to leave longer spaces between your wishes. Or you may wish to abbreviate the wish to a single word. The words are simply pointing to the feeling of metta. So learn to use them in a skillful way. As much or as little as needed. All the time making the kindness, the intention, the most important thing. for the last part of this meditation, I'd like to invite you to bring yourself into the Metta meditation. You may wish to do this simply by giving your own body and mind the attention it needs, as we did in the morning, simply relating to your experience with kindness and gentleness, allowing the body to relax. Or you may wish to include yourself with your friend, imagining you together and expanding your wish to may we be happy or peaceful or safe. Very, very gently bringing yourself in, allowing your own heart to receive those well wishes. Being very receptive, as if someone's offered you a very precious gift, a jewel. Notice the feeling in the heart, feeling in the body, as you gently extend this kindness to yourself. And if there's any resistance, allowing that resistance to be there too. Gazing upon that too with a loving, kindly eyes. as we're coming closer to the end of the meditation. Take a few moments to notice your body, how you feel. Allowing the phrases to drop away. And noticing the effect of the metta practice on your own body and mind. Coming back to a more open awareness. With an attitude of kindness. And after the third ringing of the gong, you may open your eyes.